story. Good morning, Eva.
Good morning, Lindsay. That 8-year-old staying calm and staying with her baby sister as a thief took off with her dad's car this morning. Thankfully, everyone is safe and okay. And the family telling us both kids were unharmed. Police praising the father for how he handled it all. And if you find yourself in this kind of situation, experts say stay calm, cooperate with the suspect, and call 911 once it's safe to do so. Exactly what that little 8-year-old did.
So,
it's remarkable.
So smart.
Yeah. And it happened so fast.
So
father just turns us back for a moment.
Right.
Yeah. Eva, thank you.
Glad we had a happy ending there. And coming up, our Super Bowl dream team this morning. Will Reeve is here with
having to jump on this and say, don't come for me today. I did not go to the gym yesterday.
And 3, 2, 1, I'm about to come for you.
We were going to congratulate you for getting back in the saddle.
Yeah.
And you said no.
She said on national TV yesterday that she was going back to the gym and didn't make it.
So the thing, what had happened was, they changed the schedule at the gym because I haven't been there in so long.
I know what you mean by that. And it happens when you work, you've got to get it in whenever you can.
And I have to get home before, because I have a little one I have to take care of. So
okay.
Ran out of time.
Well, today is another day. Today is another day.
Love you both. Okay. We're following a pretty major medical headline out of London, Buckingham Palace announcing that King Charles.
We're going to have to see. Chances are it's going to be pretty highly watched, though, guys.
Ike said, we'll have to see.
Yeah, I mean, it is the Super Bowl still.
Yeah.
It is.
I'm
all right,
going
Ike.
With yes.
Thank you.
There's much more ahead right here on GMA 3 on this Tuesday. What's next? It's been nearly a month since the former New Jersey governor dropped out of the Republican race for the White House.
And now he's speaking out for the first time about his decision to drop out. The hot mic moment making comments about Nikki Haley's campaign and the state of the presidential race right now. He sat down with ABC's George Stephanopoulos for this exclusive interview. It's a good sit down there, and our many thanks to George for that conversation.
And Chris Christie's new book is out today. It's called What Would Reagan Do? It's available anywhere books are sold.
Coming up next, he calls himself a walking, talking fashion encyclopedia.
Himself a walking, talking fashion encyclopedia.
And he delivers. And when he isn't talking all things style and pop culture, he's busy being the award-winning author of the Supreme Siren series. So please welcome Marcellus Reynolds to the house, everybody. And these shoes. Did you have to walk in and kill us with the shoes?
Yes, I did. Of course.
I literally saw you backstage. I was like, in the dressing rooms. I was like, your shoes. I said to you.
You're the long vong for the first thing in the morning. I know it's a little early.
Hey, but it's all good. First, I want to say congratulations. This is the third book, by the way, Supreme Sirens.
You were telling us a little bit about how this book came to be. You've done supermodels. You've done actresses, music. And there's words in this book, too.
There's
not just
words.
Pictures.
I interview as many people as I possibly can.
And Supreme Siren's iconic black woman who revolutionized music is available everywhere that books are sold. Best of luck to you, buddy.
Thank you so much. Thank you all so much.
Coming up next, why it may be a good idea to stretch dry January. Say what? Into dry February? Mm-hmm. Dr. Jen Ashton with more on that.
She's been all over social media about it.
All right, we're back now with Dr. Jen taking a look at a new study that's talking about how users of a new weight loss drug had lower blood pressure. Explain this one.
Okay, another day.
Is this a result of just the losing of the
it's
weight?
It's hard to tell. Yeah, it is.
All right, back in a moment.
I'm kidding. I love that.
All right, we're taking a look at some of your medical questions that you are asking, and here
I do in one direction and another. Number one, a cold tends to be for a prescription.
Just learn something.
Yeah, look at your snot to see if you're
there you go.
Having an infection.
That is the mommy word. That is the mommy medical word.
Your prescription for wellness.
Okay. Well, self-inspired because I have been posting on my Instagram.
Vacation at the beginning of the year.
Well, one weekend.
You're gonna pass.
Thank you.
Coming up, a love story.
Oh, those voices there. I had this clip on repeat, by the way, in my dressing room this morning. And you see why. That was a peek at the Siri new Broadway musical, Days of Wine and Roses, about a couple that is grappling with addiction.
And you may recognize those two powerhouse faces. They are leading the cast of that new show, and it's getting a lot of buzz. Please welcome back to the studio Tony Award winners Kelly O'Hara and Brian D'Arcy James.
Woo! Wow.
Y'all are so cute watching that clip together, too.
Yeah. It's funny to see it when you're not doing it. It's a very different thing. Yeah, it does.
So, Kelly, this was in many ways a passion project for you that you said took many years to see come to life. Why did you think it was so important to have it happen?
And what a treat for everyone who gets a chance to see it.
I hope they do.
All right. Well, the best of luck, guys. Again, Kelly O'Hara and Brian Darcy James, thank you very much. Good to see you guys. And you can check out Days of Wine and Roses on Broadway at Studio 54. So take your family. Take everybody.
And that is what you need to know for this Tuesday. I'm Eva Pilgrim.
I'm DeMarco Morgan.
And I'm Dr. Jen Ashton.
For all of us here at ABC News, including Kelly and Brian, have a good one, and we will see you tomorrow.